coming, and when it happens, you'll probably wish you'd done something ahead of time to make that bill smaller. Real estate expert John Adams is here now to tell us just how we can do that. What's up, man? How you doing?
Great. Back from my cruise, ready to talk real estate.
Let's do this. I'm stressing about income taxes right now, and now you're saying I got to worry about property taxes too in January? Or I guess it's February.
Actually, it's June. That's when the bill's going to come.
Right.
June 1st, usually. But now is the time to take action if you want to cut that property tax bill. And if you own real estate in Georgia, you're going to get a bill in June. Now is the time to do something about it.
Okay, so what do we need to do?
Well, first we're going to need to file what's called a property tax return.
Okay.
You need to know that in Georgia, property taxes are called an ad valorem tax. And what that means is everybody pays their fair share based on the value of the property. Now, that's where you come in, because the value of your property is pretty much a decision. You know, it's just somebody's opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe more, maybe less. And that task goes to the tax assessor. But you can have input on that, and that's what your property tax return is.
Always confusing between an assessed value and the actual value of your property.
Right.
Too.
That's the fair market value is what we talk about in real estate. And the key here is that there's absolutely no relationship whatsoever between the assessed value, which we would like to be zero,
mm-hmm.
and the fair market value, which we would love to be as high as possible. And I've had people say, well, I'm not going to appeal my taxes because I'm going to be selling the house next year. Forget about that. You want it as low as possible.
All right, so how do we come up with this value that we want to submit?
Well, remember, it's just your opinion, okay? So it can be anything. You don't have to have data, but it's best for it to be realistic. And the way we do that is base it on sales, recent sales of homes in your neighborhood that are similar to your house. They should be similar age, similar size, similar style, and they need to have sold within a year. And in this case, that would be the year of 2017, because we're talking about what is the value of your property on January 1. Most relevant sales will be during the previous 12 months.
That information is easy to find. Also, any other tips as we're looking for that?
Any real estate agent certainly can help you get that information. Buy them a cup of coffee at Starbucks. Or you can actually go on to some of the sites like Zillow or Realtor.com and get that information for free yourself. I like to, just for fun, keep up with homes that are selling year-round in my neighborhood, just so I have an idea of what's happening.
Sure.
And then first part of the year, I assemble those and say, well, which are similar to my house? And I try to come up with a realistic assessment.
Did you name this form the PT50R? And when I complete it, what in the world do I do with it?
You know, I don't know where they come up with these great names, but the PT50R is a form that you can get on my website, and that's the property tax return. I don't know where 50 came from. Maybe this is the 50th form. But nonetheless, you can go to my website at money99.com, click the button that says free property tax report, and you'll get a copy of the form as well as our special report that we have here, which walks people through the process. Really only takes about 5 minutes to fill out the form, and then we need to deliver that or mail it to the tax assessor's office.
I've never done this before. I'm going to do it this year.
By the way, some counties like Gwinnett will allow you to do it online.
So, I don't live in Gwinnett.
No, okay. Well, then drive down to downtown Decatur and deliver it yourself,
right.
Or you can mail it. Yeah. Your deadline is April 1st. Don't miss that.
All right, cool. Thanks, John. And John's going to be here to answer your real estate questions for the next hour on the Fox 5 Atlanta Facebook page, so you certainly want to take advantage of that. It's 8:36, and coming up on